Chapter 3, Schematic Readings, Module Number 4, Navy NEATS. Learning objectives. Upon completion of the chapter, you'll be able to recognize the marking symbol of the cable, including shippers and shipboard testing equipment system, recognize marking system of the wire indicating aircraft shipboard electronic equipment system, recall 7 types of electrical diagrams that are function designed for each, recall basic safety practice precaution for working on around electrical and electronic systems. Schematic. All right, schematics, reading. Chapter 1 is divided into 3 topics. Cable, and wire marking system, electric, electronic diagram, safety precaution. First, we discuss the systems used in marking cables and wires. We will then explain each type of circuits we'll encounter when troubleshooting, testing, repair, learning about the circuits and system operation. Finally, we'll briefly discuss safety practices relating to around electrical and electronic systems. Cable and warning marking system. Cable wire marking system. Cable and wires are marked to give an electrician means of tracing them on where in troubleshooting with repairing electronic systems. Numerous cable wire marking systems are used in ships, aircraft, equipment throughout the Navy. A few systems briefly discussed here and I acquaint to you that the marking systems are used for the specific system of equipment. You should refer to the applicable technical manual. Cable marking system. 2 cable marking systems are usually likely to see the shipboard test equipment cable marking system. Shipboard cable marking system. Metal tags and bows with cable markings are usually identified on permanently installed shipboard electrical cable. These cable tags are figure 3-1 are placed on the cables close to each point of the connection and both sides of the deck, bulkheads and other barriers identifying cables. These markings of the cable or tag identify the cable's maintenance circuit repairs. The tag shows the service letter, which is identify the particular electrical system. The circuit letter or letters, which identify the specific circuit particular system, and the cable number that identifies an individual cable in specific circuit. All right, your typical cable tag shows the service and the CAKT letters, the cable number, and the security tag of the cable is shown in typical marking. Figure 3-1 notes the cable marked as CBM-144. The code C denotes that the service in the case of the internal communication systems. The MB denotes that the circuit in this engine order and circuit. The number 14144 denotes the cable in the MB circuit. Test equipment cables marking system. View A, figure 2 shows the piece of the testing equipment that is used to check out the electrical electronic equipment system. Also show the cable that are used to hook the tester to the equipment. The cables have metal and plastic tags, each end showing the cable number and connecting number. Shows the tester cables, method of connection, testing jump 1, jump 2, jump 3, jump 4, equipment. Figure view B. Show the figure 2 on method of connection connecting tester piece of equipment to be tested for the specific resistor checking manual supplied by the tester. Show the method of the connection. Tester show that has 4 cables that are numbered wire 1, wire 2, wire 3, wire 4. Each of the cable connectors, the plugs on each end of the numbered parallel are numbered. Connector plugs are numbered P1, P2. The cable tag on the end of the cable reads wire 1 to plug 1. Other one reads wire 1 to plug 2. Shown figure. One wire one plug one is connected to the receptacle J1 on the tester, and the J1 wire one plus plug two is connected to the receptacle J1 on the equipment to be tested. Same procedure, just as connecting the remaining 3 cables hook up. It is then to complete. The shipboard testing equipment cable markings just discussed are only the 2 main cable marking systems just you may encounter. There are too many systems to attempt to discuss them all. As stated care earlier, you should study the equipment installation and technical manual before attempting repairs or connections. Wire marking system. Wire marking system are used to identify the wires in the aircraft shipboard electronic equipment and pool with power tool and appliance cables. Aircraft wire marking system. All aircraft wires identify the wire diagrams exactly and the wire is marked in the aircraft. Each of the wires coded with a combination of letters and numbers and printed on the wires prescribed in the intervals along the wire. Shows circuit function P, wire number 215, wire segment letter, and wire size number and ground phase letter. Aluminum. Look at the figure 3-3, the circuit function letter P is in the example to identify the basic function circuit concern. The P indicates the wire on the DC power distribution of the aircraft. The wire number 215 indicate the 215th wire of the DC distribution system. The wire segment letter identifies the position of each of the wire segment of the circuit. Wire segments are lettered in an alphabetical sequence change each time the wire passes through the terminal and connector. For this example, after the wire passes through the first terminal connector, segment letter A is in the instance it would be in change B. Wire subnet number, wire size number 4 over the AN wire size. The AN wire size has no more strands of the flexibility and are single, slightly different with the circular mill area than the American wire gauge wire size. The current carrying capacity, each of these almost the same. Letter N is the ground or phase letter. The letter N identifies any wire complete with the circuit ground network of the aircraft. In the three-phase AC power distribution system, the phases letter A, B, and C are used with the last letter added with the wire marking. Aluminum wires used in conductor aluminum or ALUM will be added as a suffix to the wire identification code. Shipboard electronic equipment wire marking system. The following explanation is an example of the type of the conductors making used in shipboard electronic equipment. These conductors may be contained in the cables within the equipment. Cables within the equipment are usually numbered by the manufacturer. These numbers will be found in technical manual for the equipment. If the cables connect the equipment, they must be in the compartments on the ship. They will be marked on the shipboard cable numbering system previously described. On the conductor lead end of the near of the point of the connection with the terminal post, spaghetti sleeving is used to marking the material in an insulator. The sleeving is marked with identifying numbers and letters. Then slid over the conductor, marking the sleeve, identify that the conductor connects both them to and from, given the following information, figure 3-4. All right, your spaghetti sleeving shows the terminal board 101 to terminal 2A with a terminal board to terminal TB 401 and SB terminal 2 SB. Okay, and then the conductor and the cable. The term from and terminal board 2 and terminal 2, the designation of the sleeving separated by the after the order of markings and such that the first set number of the leads of the letter reads to the left and right designation corresponding to the terminal from which the conductor runs following the number with the terminal board to which the conductor runs. The terminal board is omitted with the sleeve that is to be marked. The third designation is a terminal 2, which the conductor runs. For example, as shown in figure 3-4, where the conductor is attached to terminal 2A with the terminal board 101, terminal 2A with the spaghetti sleeving. The designation of the next designation on the sleeve in the 401 indicating the going of the terminal 401, last designation 7B indicating it is attached to terminal 7B of the terminal board 401. The spaghetti marking on the other end of the conductor is reading the same way the conductor is going from the terminal 7B to the terminal 401, terminal 2A of the terminal board 101. On the occasion it is being necessary to run conductors from the two units but there are no terminal boards, for example the junction box. In this case, easily recognized abbreviation may be used to place terminal board number spaghetti sleeving designation JB2 indicate that the conductor is connected to a junction box number 2A conductor to the junction box number 2 on the piece of equipment would be identified as shown in figure 3-5. In the same manner, the plug should be identified as an P, the P number of the wood is substituted with the terminal board and making it marking on the sleeve. So you'd have terminal board 401, S1, or do junction box 2 at terminal number 4. Power tool and appliance marking systems. As the wire and cable numbering systems go so far, there are many color coding systems using electrical and electronic application. The color coding systems go here is in the one with the color, one of the coding of the conducts, power tool, and appliances. An electronic power tool appliance is required to have three-wire cable. The conductors in the cable cable are color-coded black, white, and green. The short base of the civilian facilities, one side of the electrical equipment is ground. The ground side is called the common, and the color is colored white. The other input is called the line, or the hot side is colored black. The green conductor is connected to the ground to frame the appliance or the tool. Board chip neither side of the ground, therefore both sides are confined with a fire. Both are hot. Black and white conductors may be connected on either line since there are no difference. The green conductor is connected to the ground. The ground aboard the ship is a ship hull. The purpose of the ground wire green is to prevent electrical shock to the operator in the case of the electrical short of the frame, appliance, or a tool. It's absolutely essential that personal electrical ratings may be read, but they interpret at various types of electrical diagrams. Personal working with these ratings commonly refer to all electrical diagrams as schematics. This term is not a correct habit, but the schematic is a specific type of the diagram's character of its own with a specific purpose. Each of the various diagrams discussed in the chapter have specific purposes distinguished with the features that set it apart from the other diagrams discussed, and may be used with the following purposes: to learn specific system operation, to locate components of the system, to identify the components of the system, to trace the circuit, troubleshoot equipment, or to repair the of the equipment. Would you have completed the subject, you would be able to recognize the relationship between various diagrams, the distinguishing feature of the purpose of each of the type of the diagram, a continuing reference to the figures. The text should be understood with the subject matter more clearly. We'll use a specific special diagram drawing for the electrical system of an automobile to explain the various electrical diagrams and how to read them. or your pictorial diagram. The simple oval-diagram pictorial diagram shows the picture of the sketch of the various components. Specifically, says some of the wiring parts, wiring between these components. The specified diagram provides a means to readily identify the components of the system, even if they are not familiar with the physical appearance. The type of the diagram shows the various components without regard to the physical location. However, the wires is marked. However, the wiring is routed. It does, however, show the sequence in which the components are connected. Figure 3.6 is a particular pictorial diagram in automotive starting ignition system. Are not already in failure. Is not already familiar with the components of the system side of the diagram, you should then be able to recognize the physical appearance of each of the components and the interconnections with the other components of the system. Alright, figure 3.6 shows the pictorial diagram automotive start ignition. So you have the battery going to the solenoid, and then the solenoid going to the start on switch, ignition resistor, ignition coil, distributor, and spark plug. The isometric diagram. Personally, the isometric diagram is this locating the component within the system. If you do not know where to look at the component, the isometric diagram is considered the value to you. This type of the diagram shows the outline of ship, airline, piece of equipment. When the outline or the drawing various components of the system, the respective location, isometric diagrams also show the interconnecting cable running from these components. Figure 3.7 shows an isometric diagram portion of the same automobile starting lighting position systems discussed in pictorial figure 3.6. The battery starter and other components can now be seen each of the actual locations within the automobile. Alright, so you have the ground and the battery going to the starter and the the starter going to the voltage regulator alternator and the instrument panel with the going to the headlight side panel light and rear side panel light and tail lights and tag lights. Alright, a block diagram is used primarily to present a general description of the system and its function. The diagram is generally used with the conjunction of the text material. Block diagram shows the major components of the system and interconnection with the components. All components are shown in block form. Each block is labeled to identify occasion purpose. Block diagram shows figure 8 with the illustration of automobile's electrical power. Starting the ignition system must be emphasized with the following explanation. Primarily for the purpose of assisting you to learn to read and interpret the block diagram. The explanation of the function of the automobile starting with the ignition system. Secondary importance. By tracing them from the component for the blocking diagram, follow these explanations. You're given the general description of system functions. In addition, you should be understand the arrangement of the components in the block diagram. So for the battery, I'm going to the starter, the alternator, and the alternator going back to the battery, the starter going to the ignition switch, the ignition coil, and then distributor spark plugs 1 through 6. The battery and the internal source of the power starter ignition system starter is turned by the power of the battery with the ignition switch turned to the start position. Power is also supplied through the ignition switch to the coil. From the coil, the power is supplied to the distributor, finally to the spark plugs for the ignition. Once the engine running, the starter is no longer required. There's any access, and it's a primary movement of the alternator is accomplished through the belt and pulley system attached to the engine. Crankshaft, the alternator now takes over the power supply with the ignition supply. System the power supply for the power through the ignition switch to the coil with the distributor, finally the distributor of the spark plugs. At the same time, the alternator supplies power back to the voltage regulator to battery charging purposes. This completes the cycle of the engine over the shutdown start again. Note that the engine is not shown in the block diagram. Primary move of the alternator. The engine is mechanical rather than electrical function. The illustrated block diagram is an electrical system only. Therefore, the block diagram houses strictly mechanical components of both mechanical and electronic components. Alright, a single line diagram. Single line diagram is used basically for the same purpose of the block diagram. When used in the text material, give it the basic understanding of the function of the components of the system. There are two major differences between a single line diagram and a block diagram. The first difference is that the single line diagram uses symbols rather than labeled blocks to represent the components. Second line diagram shows all the components in a single line. Figure 3.9, there are no interconnections from the self component, so which shown in the block diagram. For example, the alternator voltage regulator back to the battery. The single line diagram is very simplified. It should be used primarily to learn in very broad terms the function each of various components as the part of the total system. Alright, the single line diagram shows the battery to the starter, the alternator, the voltage regulator, and the switch, ignition switch, ignition coil, distributor, and spark plug. The schematic diagram. The schematic diagram shows the meaning of the graphic symbol, the electrical connection, function of the specific circuit arrangement. The schematic diagram is used to trace the circuit within the functions with regard to the actual physical size and shape, location of the component device and part. The schematic diagram is most useful of all diagrams learning overall system operations. Figure 3.10 is schematic diagram in automobile electrical system. Automobile electrical system, even the frame of the automobile is conducted. The frame is called the ground side. The figure 3.10 shows that the electrical components grounded on one side. The negative side of the battery is also grounded. Therefore, the frame is negative conductor of the system. The opposite of the end of each of the components connected through the switch of the positive side of the battery. For the purpose of the teaching in the schematic reading, we will discuss only the lighting system and engine instruments. All right, you have your starter, or alternator, voltage regulator, FT, green light, battery, solenoid, starter, voltage regulator, alternator, green light, water temperature element, oil pressure, switch, gas gauge, tank for the gas, on an ignition resistor, on an ignition switch, or the start, ignition coil, capacitor, condenser, point, ground and point, You have the fuse light off switch park on the from the connection capacitor condenser, the distributor park plugs 1 through 6, the light switch on parking dimmer switch, the headlights and the parking brakes connected to the fuse that hold on to the tail and stop lights, and they are on a brake light switch, and also the tag lights and the side panel lights. Positive side of the 12-volt is connected to the starter cylinder with terminal B over the voltage regulator, then point down the 1 should be noted that 1, 2, and 3, and 4, 1, 2, 3 on the normally is indicated in the schematic. They also show they are here only the help to be followed with the diagram. There is no faults on the system. Point 1 and 2, 1 is the 12-volt positive potential at all times. This positive potential can be traced to the fuse on the off position with the light switch. The dashed line indicates mechanical linkage of the switch. This switch is pulled with the first position of the number 12 park when volts are applied to the point 2. It can now be seen that the tail lights of the tag light in the side panel lights or an instrument light have the 12 volts. Apply the opposite end of outside of each of the light with the ground and the instrument panel have a ground through the dimming resistor rheostat. The computer's both on the current from the negative side of the battery through all the light bulbs and lamps back to the positive side of the battery. No faults exist. The lamp's lights when the lamp light switch pulled the next on position on the bar switch contains the off the parked on contact switch. The lights were eliminated before they are still on, but with the number 12 volt potential now applied with the bright side of the headlights through the dimmer switch, since the headlights are grounded on the most side of the now complete path with the current flow through, the headlights are lit. The dimmer switch is actuated. The positive potential switch from the bright filament to the dim filament of the headlights and the light dimmer. The brake light switch is 12 volts applied with the point 1 directly with the stoplight not fused in. The brake light press with the switch actuated. The number 12 volts applied with the both stoplights because one on side of each light with the side to the ground, the path of the current flow of the light will light. Dimming the rheostat instrument light is determined by the direction of the increase in resistance. More of the voltage drop across the rheostat left across the lights. The lights will get dimmer. But for 12 volt point, if point ones are spotted with the opposition ignition switch, when the ignition switch is turned on, the 12 volts are felt with at point 3 with a common point on all the instrument engines. Engine. The gas gauge of the galvanometer, the dial graduated corner with the amount of fuel in the tank. The gas gauge of the tank of the rheostat mechanically light and linked with the flow over the gas tank. With the tank is full, with the full whereas at the highest level, the position. Movable bar arm rheostat position minimum the resistance allowable maximum current flow over the galvanometer. The dial resists the full mark over the gas gauge as the fuel over the engine of the float lowers increase with the resistance over the rheostat ground reduce the current through the galvanometer dial shoe the lesser amount of the fuel meter. Of the fuel. The oil pressure lights gets in the ground through the normally closed pressure switch where there's no pressure is applied with the switch closed. When the engine starts and it started the oil pressure increase that opens the switch, turns the light off by removing the ground. The water temperature gauge in the galvanometer with the gas gauge except with the dial graduated in the degree of the temperature of the water temperature element of the thermostat with the negative temperature coefficient of the thermostat of the semiconductor device with the resistance varies from the temperature when the engine is cold. The resistance of the thermostat is at maximum. This is reduced the current through the galvanometer with the low temperature of the gauge. The temperature is indicated on the dial. As the water temperature on the engine the increase of the resistance of the thermostat decreases, this allows more current to flow over the ground, but the galvanometer, the temperature on the dial shows an increase. On the voltage regulator, show the T-terminal ground with any time of the alternator does not have any output. This gives the alternator tight light on the ground causes it to eliminate. Alright, your wire diagram. A wire diagram is a detailed diagram of each of the circuit insulation showing all the wiring, the conductor, connectors, terminal boards, electrical components, and circuit. They also identify the wire numbers, the color coding. Wire diagrams are necessary to troubleshoot and repair electronic circuits. Wire diagram for an automobile is shown in figure 311 and show the electrical components that those interconnecting wires is color coded. Alright, and then you have the same crazy drawing again, like. You should use the schematic diagram previously discussed to determine the trouble that might be in the circuit of the malfunction. A curve of the schematic diagram does not show the terminal connectors points, so forth, over the circuit. Therefore, you must go to the circuit wiregram to determine where to make the voltage resistance. Check the circuit for the troubleshooting. Following is an example of how to use the schematic diagram in junction with the wiregram as troubleshooting a circuit. In the discussion schematic diagram, you will recall the light switches pulled on the park position, the taillights and side panel lights and attack light and the instrument lights come on. Now, suppose that the light switches pulled into the park position, the lights come on and accept the tag. And then referring to the schematic diagram 310, you will recall that when the light switch is placed on the park position, 12 volts are applied with the point 2, the lights come on and accept the tag light, then the fault must be in between the two on the tag light ground. On schematic diagram figure 311, you can see that there are numerous connections to the point 2 with the point 2 wire diagram actually composed with the three different functions, terminal 1 on terminal board 1. Headlamp junction box, terminal 1 and 2, terminal board 2, the tamp light and table light junction box, and terminal of the light switch, they all correspond with the point 2 with the schematic. The fault here is the tag light, which normally receives 12 volts with the terminal 1 and terminal board 2. View the voltmeter to find the fault. Place the positive lead of the voltmeter to the ground terminal of the tail attack light and the negative lead of to the frame. The voltmeter should read zero, but because there should be no difference between the potential between the two points. If the reader meets a voltage, the ground lead is either open or high resistant connection, the meter reads zero. You will have to go to another test point and then cave the place of the positive voltmeter lead of the positive terminal over the taillight. If the voltmeter reads 12 volts, the light bulb is probably burned out or the light socket is defective. If the voltmeter reads zero, then open is between the terminal 1 and terminal board 2 of the light. Your terminal diagram. Terminal diagrams view the connection wire, the terminal boards, relay switches, and other components of the trigger. Figure 312 shows the two typical terminal diagrams. View A of the figure shows the wire numbers of each connected with each terminal and terminal board. View B shows the different color codes of the wires that are connected to the relay. All right, so the terminal board shows... you have B20 to D, B23 to D and E, B3 to 6, B3 to 1, and then your typical terminal board diagram, and then typical delay terminal diagram, red for the red, white, yellow, green, black, or 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Red, white, yellow, green, black. The brief overview of the use of the interpretation electrical diagram. The diagram gives us like because of the simpler and easier interpretation. Many diagrams will encounter for the far more complex starter. The simpler diagram you will work on on the job proficiency. The more complex diagrams will improve the experience in the study. Or in safety, the security of the Navy, establishing the Department of Navy Safety Program, stress safety of the inherent responsibility of the command, further outline and assignment of the safety responsibility of all echelon command of the basic requirement, the main need the reasonable ability, write down the lowest rated personnel in the command. Most non-combat accidents can be prevented if all of the personnel cooperate and eliminate unsafe conditions and acts to end this individual responsible for the understanding, applying safety rules and standard regulations in all activities. Safety consciousness will help prevent personal injury damage to the property. Some safety precautions of applicable to the module deal with the fumes and synthetic insulation, breathing asbestos, fibers, and working around electronic equipment, circuits, portable power tools. Or synthetic insulation, almost exemption of the fusion of the synthetic materials such as plastic, high temperature environments, objectual standpoint, health and safety, fluoroplastics, and polyethyl, resistant decomposition, higher temperature, better than most other plastics. Exposure to the fumes working with the fluoroplastics may cause temporary flu-like conditions similar to the metal fume fever or foundry man's fever. The system of the commonly called the polymer fume fever that do not ordinarily occur with several hours after the exposure passed with 36 and 40 hours, 8 hours of event, even in the absence of treatment. One of the large uses of fluoroplastics is wire with a cable insulation wire. Insulated wiring is insulated soldering of the routine fabric procedure. Either the heated element of the removal of the insulation, either operational combined effect of the temperature, quantity of the resin exposure, the time, product, the house condition, the significant, as long as the normal ventilation is ventilated and maintained. In special practice, the precautions that may be required should be followed with the same common sense rules that all soldering jobs. Prolonged soldering is confined space with restricted air current circulation, requires some ventilation to perform personal comfort. Same is true with the open shop area with where a number of personnel engaged in soldering and hot wiring. Strictly normal ventilation for the personal comfort that you have to provide adequate safety. However, the recommended that small conduct fan, elephant trunk exhaust may be used with the working bench during the soldering and the white strip to carry away the toxic vapors. Asbestos. All asbestos-free products have been developed. Other older products containing asbestos materials still exist and contain to be used in the Navy. The one such of the asbestos insulation used on wiring at high temperature air for the areas abroad, ships, and aircraft. Because of the serious health hazards of asbestos exposure, government has imposed strict occupational healthy environmental protection standards for the control of the asbestos. These standards must be strictly enforced by followed by all Navy personnel. Asbestos is a general term that describes in several fibers, mineral silicates, include the asbestos cement product, floor tile, fireproofing, high temperature insulation, asbestos cloth, function materials such as brake lines, clutch facings, various gasket materials, miscellaneous other products. Inhaling asbestos fibers can produce disabling fatal fibrosis for the lungs. Fibrosis for the lungs, asbestos comes from inhaling asbestos fiber. Asbestos is a factor that develops in lung cancer as well as the cancer of the gastrointestinal tract. This may take 20 to 40 years between the initial exposure to the asbestos, the appearance for the cancer condition. Nowhere with the asbestos in the environment, avoid, take precautions to prevent exposure. Electrical and electronic equipment, portable power tools, the working electronics, we must observe the general precautions. The following list is the common sense of safety precautions you must observe at all times. Remember, the electronic circuits often have more than one source of power. To take the time to study the schematic wire diagrams, the entire system to ensure all the power sources are deactivated. Remove all the metal objects from your person. Use one hand when turning switches on and off to keep the doors and switch and fuse box closed, except for the working side replacing fuses. After the first making certain that the circuit is dead, use the fuse puller, figure 313, to remove the cartridge. switches, and figure 313 show the fuse puller. Supply switches, cutout switches for the other, with the power could be possibly fed, should be secured in the off and on an open safety position. Tag 314. Tagging procedure must be done in accordance with the appropriate manual instruction of your field training or your field training. These are your tags. Danger tag. Do not operate with equipment within danger of the personnel or the harm of the equipment. The equipment shall not be operated until this tag has been removed by the authorized personnel. All right, keep clothing, hands, and feet dry with as possible and necessary to work on the wet and damp location of the drive platform. Wooden stool to sit or stand on. Place the rubber mat or other non-conductive material on the top of the wood. Use insulated tools and molded insulated flashlight when you're required to work on exposed parts. All instances of repairs in the inner drive circuit must be made on primary power applied except in an emergency, and then only after the specific approval has been given by the commander officer. When approval has been obtained to work on the equipment, the power is applied. Keep one hand free at all times behind you and one in your pocket. Never short out, tamper with, or block an open interlocking switch. Keep clear of the exposed equipment when necessary to work on it. Work with one hand as much as possible. Avoid reaching into exposure except with absolutely necessary when reaching into an enclosure with rubber blankets to prevent accidental contact with an enclosure. Make certain the equipment is properly grounded. Turn off the power before connecting alligator clips to any circuit. Never use the finger to test a hotline. Use approved voltmeters or other volt indicating devices. High voltage precautions. In addition, with observing the general precautions just discussed, you must observe the following additional precautions when working with high voltage. Do not work with a high voltage by yourself. Have any other person, safety observer, qualified in the field or state of electrical shop present at all times. The individual stational nearby should also know the circuit of the location of the switch of the control of the equipment. Should be given the instruction to pull the switch immediately if any of the unforeseen happens. Always be aware of the nearest high voltage lines and circuit. Use the rubber gloves where applicable, stand on improved rubber mat, not also called rubber mats, are good insulators. Always discharge the high voltage from the components and terminals using a safety probe. Do not toll the test probe when the circuits are over 300 watts or 300 volts are tested. Soldering irons. When using soldering irons, always keep in mind with the following precautions and procedures. To avoid burns, always assume the soldering iron is hot. Never rest a heated iron anywhere but on a metal surface or rack provided for the purpose. If actual faulty action on your part could result in fire, extensive equipment damage, and serious injuries. Never use excessive amount of solder since dip rings can may cause serious burns, skin burns, and eye burns. Do not swing an iron to remove the excess solder bit of hot solder that removed in this manner because it causes serious skin or eye burns. Hot solder may also ignite combustible materials in the working area. When cleaning an iron, use clean cloth. Do not hold the clean cloth in your hand. Always place the cloth on a suitable surface and wipe the iron across it and prevent burning from your hand. Holding smaller soldering jobs while applying pliers and suitable clamping devices to avoid burns. Never hold the work in your hands. Do not use iron that has frayed cord or damaged plug. Do not solder components unless the equipment is connected from the power supply circuit. Disconnected from the power supply circuit. Severe burns and death can result with the contact with high voltage. After completing the task requiring the use of the soldering iron, disconnect the power cord from the receptacle and with the iron which has cooled, stow it in an assigned storage area. Power electrical power tools. Navy specification portable electrical power tools require electrical cord to each have the distinctive mark over the ground and wire addition conductors for supplying power to the tool. Doubly insulated power electrical tools have the same source of the qualified under the applicable Minnesota specification except for the grounding requirement. The end of the ground wire within the tool must be connected with the metal housing of the tool. The other end of the connector to the positive ground. The ground connection specifically designed a ground type of plug with receptacle will automatically make connection with the plug insert with the receptacle may be used. The ground type of the receptacle must be installed in all power outlets where installed, but the mirror must be with the ground and type of the plugs. Ground portable tools and equipment with the ground type of the receptacles have not been installed. They must be installed as soon as possible. Portable tools are not provided with a ground type plug. Miscellaneous portable electrical equipment that does not have the cord or ground conductor ground plug must be given the 3-conductor cord with a standard Navy ground type plug. The ground wire must be connected to a positive ground. The care must be exercised to connect the plugs and cord. The ground conductor of the cord must be connected with the ground contact of the plug at one end of the metal equipment housing at the other end of the cord must be arranged so no creating the tripping hazard. If the conductor is connected to the mechanical equipment housing and inadvertently connected with the line connecting the plug, the dangerous potential would be placed on the equipment casing. This could result in fatal shocks to the operator. If the cord is pulled loose, the plug is only qualified electrician is authorized to prepare it. If the ground type plugs receptacles have not been installed in the space where the portable tool is used, the other type of plugs receptacles may be used only if the separated ground wire is connected between the tool housing and pop of the ground. When the tool cord does not include any extra wire for the grounding, additional insulated wire should be connected between the metal housing of the tool, the ground, and the tool housing. Two more conducting parts of the non-electrical connected to each of the mount must be connected to the ground wire connection of the ground wire of the tool housing and the grounding must be then by me. If the screw or bolts will be using the spring clips for either end of the ground wire is prohibited. When grounding connections to be made means other contact with the plug receptacle, care must be taken to ensure the good contact between the ground wire and the metal with the scraping away from the paint with the metal, ensure the clean surface of the ground connection must be made before inserting the power supply connecting plug. Plug must be pulled out before removing the ground connection. Frequency inspection each of the connection of the portable electrical tool must be made with ensure that the supply cord with the connection with the tool suitable insulated with the ground connection and intact. The safety precautions are discussed and are protected with your equipment. Follow the safety precautions. Do not take the chance of the carelessness could cost your life. In Chapter 3 Summary.